Hello Pisces, welcome to my channel Love It or More. This is your May 2022 reading for Sun, Moon and Rising. It is a general reading, so take what resonates, leave the rest behind. And if you do resonate with this, please do like, subscribe, comment and share. We will start off with the sound bowl just to tune into the energies. So if you'd like to take a nice breath in and exhale. Okay, Pisces, let's see what May has in store for you. We would be doing three rows. The first row will be your current energy surrounding you for the month of May, as you begin the month of May. The middle row will be anything that's unseen, any surprises or challenges or obstacles coming your way. And the final row will be your result, your outcome. And I'll be cutting the deck. Okay. Current energy, fulfillment. Oh, nice big peach with that full moon. Okay. Let's see what else we have. I'm going to lay out quite a few cards before I start reading. I've just noticed something with the fulfillment card here. Don't know if you can see that, but in the background over here, there are horses in a field. I've never noticed that before. Horses represent free spirit. Right, okay. Huh? We have two moons. Good Lord, I didn't notice that either. Two full moons. Now, full moons basically represent full completion, full manifestation or a release, right? The ending of something, the culmination of something. And with the peach here, it's basically saying the harvest is ripe for the picking. And it's like a double whammy. But of course, the peach could also represent that third moon. So the fulfillment feels like you are feeling quite satisfied. But at the same time, you've got freedom to roam the fields with the horses there. Go the distance. Okay, with the cheetah spirit over there is your challenge. So it may be that you are feeling quite nurtured, quite fulfilled in some area of your life, and it's asking you to reach a bit further with a bit more pace. Thank you. Right. And then, lovely. I love this card. You're already doing it. Stop overthinking. Keep facing your true north. That would be the calling card from spirit, the advice from spirit. Okay, let's see what the major arcanas are coming for you. Oh. Okay. Current energy starts of the month, patience. Obstacles, challenges, the Hierophant. Outcome for the month, justice. Thank you very much. And we're going to be clarifying with the Fountain deck. Let's see. Okay, so while I've been shuffling, I've just been looking at these two cards. So both cards are a five because 14 reduces to a five and the Hierophant is a five. Okay, 14, four, one plus four is five, right? Numerology. Now, fives are always about challenges and obstacles. But what I was really focusing on is when you take a 14, if you just look at the one talks about a new beginning and the four talks about grounding something, putting it in. Implementing it in the physical earth, into reality, into your physical reality. So that's why the patience card is here, because it's saying the thing that you want to do, you want to implement it, but you can't just yet. So there's a lag, and the challenge is the time it takes to do so. Okay, we're going to get two cards for each. Let's have a look. We have the Empress, really nice. And the sun, good Lord, guys. You see, what did I say? It's all happening for you. Right, we have the seven of coins. This is where things are taking a wee bit longer to manifest or see in your reality. And the page of cups, some good news coming in. Thank you very much. And for the outcome, we have five of wands. So it talks a bit about conflict there. And the king of wands. So maybe dealing with somebody else. Okay. Sort of boss figure. So you start off in a very strong position as you begin May off. Okay. Things are kind of, things are reaching a fulfilling time for you. And what's really, really wonderful about all of this is that the Empress and the Sun comes up in the place of patience, meaning that as you have waited for that, reaping that reward of that harvest that you've pulled in now, the hard work that you've put in, the blood, sweat and tears that you've put in, because our mages, I don't have any details yet, but we're going to clarify further, don't worry, okay? But the beautiful thing about this is that the timing is perfect. It is a divine timing. And in this lull, let's just put it that way, you are sort of recalibrating, putting things back into perspective, and you're now moving from the place of the heart space, that unconditional love with the with the Empress, that creativity, that nurture from the heart space. And then the Sun brings illumination to all of it, meaning that the Sun, the peach wouldn't be able to ripen without the Sun, right? But the Sun not only brings illumination, it brings things to harvest. Things are prosperous. You're feeling a joyful energy and a very nurturing energy. So the Sun is very masculine energy. The Empress is a very feminine energy. And you've got this beautiful divine counterpart between the two, which is really nice. Then it's asking you to go the distance over here. And it feels like it may be a little bit of a challenge, because this is a really good place to be in, okay? It's like you're just working with the natural flow and the natural order of things, which is really in harmony with you. And it's beautiful. But now it's asking you to go a little bit further, okay? Now it's asking you to reach further, whether that be reaching higher in your spirituality, or whether that's reaching for more information, more knowledge, more wisdom with the Hierophant. Now, the Hierophant can also talk about organizations, okay? Institutions, big collectives of people where you, whatever you want to implement in the world, you have to kind of, you know, sometimes there's red tape, sometimes there's bureaucracy. And in order to plant your next harvest over here, plant your next seeds, you might have to kind of, it just feels kind of like a bit frustrating. And that's all I'm feeling with this, because going the distance is like, okay, well, you've reached a really, really good place, but now it's asking you to stretch even further. And you're like, well, why not? Why can't I just enjoy this? Why can't I just like indulge in this? And it's saying, well, no, you can actually take this to a whole new level. For the next season, to go deeper, to go deeper. So whether that be deep in your spirituality, or whether that's going further in your career, or anything that you're manifesting, bringing to life, creating with that Empress, it's also, I do feel like perhaps there could be situations where if you need, let's say, approval from institutions or permissions, then it's gonna take a bit of time, and it may be a little complicated. But it's saying, because of all of this, you're in a very strong position to go the distance. So do so. And then we got the Page of Cups, which is a loving message, a wonderful good news coming in for you. So if you can reach that a little bit further, even though you feel like you just want to celebrate in what you have at the moment, it's saying it's going to catapult you that much further. Then we've got justice. And justice only turns up when there has been sort of an injustice. So there could be something perhaps even related to the Hierophant here, if you're dealing with any kind of legal systems with institutions. And there could have been a bit of conflict with regarding that. You know, with when you deal with anything of a legal nature, there is usually two sides to a story, right? and you're sort of defending your rights. Now, it may cause quite a fair bit of conflict, and it could be to do with a boss figure or someone who is of a particular standing. When I say that, what I mean is authoritative standing over you. I don't feel this is your energy here. I feel like this is someone else, and it's causing conflict in that situation. But with the Justice card coming up and you're already doing it, I would say that justice will work in your favor, and you don't have to overanalyze these situations. Okay, so let's clarify and see how this is really affecting you, because you've got three major arcanas, which are currents of energy. It doesn't give me detail, so I want to get a little bit further. Can we see what the Empress, Page of Swords, anything else? King of Swords, right, lots of information coming through there for you. The Sun, please, it's coming to light. The Emperor, I do like that. And again, very masculine energy there. And the Chariot, yes, okay. So there is, I do feel like you are, as you start the month off, you get some good communication that's coming in that's gonna enable you to create something for yourself. So when I have to be general, right? Because it's a general reading. But the Empress, she is all about birthing new things in, okay? Being creative, being nurturing. And we've got some, I would say, very powerful news coming through the Page of Swords. He's a messenger of information, okay? And some really good news coming in through, and probably from two places as well, but through the King of Swords, which could even relate to the Hierophant here and the Justice card, because the King of Swords generally tends to be someone of an official standing, of a certain level of authority, with representing a major institutional government or organization. Okay, and what I see here is that to have the patience, because the news is going to be very, it's going to be good. It's going to be good. It's going to enable you to do these creative things. But it may require that they may come forward and say, for example, you've bought a property and now you want to build a house on it. That would be the Empress energy. I'm giving an example here. But you can't do it yet, which is why the patience is here. Because even though you want your plot of land, you want to plant your own seeds and have your own vegetable garden or whatever, even though you want to do that, you need to now apply for permission, planning permission, okay? So I do feel, so this is an example of the energy, meaning that you are going to get the A-OK with it, but it's going to take a bit of time, okay? What's really lovely about it is that the illumination, the sun, basically brings this green light for you to that you are going to be now, you are now going to be able to be the Emperor. You're going to be able to get on your chariot and ride off into the sunset, you know. So you are going to be put in a position, if you allow the time to just play out as it will, you will have the power that the Emperor has. And the power that the Emperor has is he has all of his, I want to say disciples, but people who work underneath him, who are playing their part to serve his needs, his vision. And his vision really is sort of overlooking his whole kingdom. So he's got a piece, he understands the bigger picture of things. And when you understand the bigger picture, you're looking quite ahead into the future. So in that way, you are strategically planning your way forward for the future and where you want to move towards, and then chariot, you can drive forward. But I do feel, because all of this is under the patience card, because patience would be the anchoring card, I do feel that all of these green lights that you're getting is very, very exciting. It's making you feel very fulfilled. It's like you've got the green light, but you can't do anything yet, okay? Now it's asking you to go the distance. So let us have a look at the Seven of Coins. Whoa. Let's do that all again. I'll take you, which is the Strength card. Anything else? For Seven of Coins, please. Anything else for Seven of Coins? Thank you. And the Magician. Yes. Okay. So again, with this, it's about kind of contacting the powers that be to implement this new, this desire, this the thing that you want to be the emperor of. So it could relate as, I don't see it relating to kind of emotions and love, but it could be like, for example, it could in a way, if it was, for example, you wanted to move house to be closer to a family member so you can help support them, being the emperor and being the lead and taking a role in that, but you can't do it just yet because you have to wait for immigration stuff, right? It could also be a new job that you want to do, but again, you may need to get a certain qualification, and it's going to take a bit of time with the Seven of Coins, and I feel like you're a bit worried that the longer it takes, the drive that you have, that fire in your belly, might burn out. But I wouldn't worry about that, because it's basically saying go the distance, go the full way, do whatever it takes. So do the research to find out what more you need to do with whatever you are creating at this time. So it could even be like, for example, if you were pregnant with the Empress, that's all about pregnancy as well, then it would be like you're very excited and you've got these plans about where you're gonna get the baby room or the nursery and all that sort of stuff. But it's saying go the distance, make sure that you buy all the make sure that you financially set up where you can, perhaps see if there's some family members close by that can help support you, get everything sorted. Okay, go the distance. So let's go to the Page of Cups, please, because you're manifesting it. So that's fine with the Magician. You're creating it. This is all in your creation, which is beautiful. Okay. As it relates to work, sorry, I'll just add this as well. As it relates to work, if you're setting something up new for yourself, a new enterprise, even if it's on the side, it's basically saying you will... It's all in your favor, absolutely, but reach that little bit further. Okay, how so? For example, you may have the meat of this particular endeavor, but add some fat to it, you know, add some frills to it, add some sizzle to it. So let's look at Page of Cups. Go the full distance, put it all in, but through within the rules and the regulations of the Hierophant. Okay. Okay, Four of Pentacles. Anything else, please? No. Okay, so I do feel that the Page of Cups, with regards to this matter over here, with that Four of Pentacles, it's basically going to say that I feel like you're going to be getting some good news coming in that's going to encourage you to... it's going to enable you to put some money aside or put some resources aside to serve going the distance with this. Because a Page of Cups is a messenger. It's news coming in, right? Good news coming in that's come from the heart space. So it's got a loving, compassionate intention behind this offering for you, this green light. And with it comes the, I would say, advice to... maybe be a bit careful of your spending and squirrel some aside that it's going to serve you later down the line. Okay, so it's good news, which is wonderful, but it may even be an offering of even though I don't have the Six of Pentacles here, or the Ten of Pentacles, it could even be a sort of a monetary offer or sponsorship or something like that. I would savor that or save it. That would be wise to do. Right, with the Justice card, let's look at Five of Wands, please. Why is the Five of Wands here? Whoa, okay. We have the Hierophant again. Wheel of Fortune, thank you. The Tower, the Hermit, Ten of Pentacles. Well, there you've got your money, that's for sure. It seems to me like, with Justice coming in, it seems to me that you are getting a payout from some sort of institution or government system or pension scheme or something like that. And it comes as a surprise. And with the Wheel of Fortune with the Justice card basically means this is your turn. Lady Justice has turned up and said, well, now you've got something owing to you, so we're gonna award it to you. But I do feel like it's coming as a bit of a shock. And maybe what it's causing is a little bit of internal conflict because of the Hermit card, doing some introspection, trying to figure out how is the best way to handle this, to share it or whatever. But it's, instead of it being like, yay, I feel like it's just causing a bit of anxiety there, a bit of conflict. And perhaps you've got now people biting at the bit. Is that the nipping at the bite? I don't know what the expression is where the horse bites. Anyway, there could be people coming towards you wanting a piece of your pie, basically. So that's where the conflict might be coming in. Let's have a look at this King of Wands, please. Why is the King of Wands here? Thank you. And then the Four of Swords. So I would say then whatever the situation is, if it was a legal matter, some sort of legal situation with the King of Wands, you will be healing from it. For all else of you, whatever this deserving return comes in for you, not only do you need to recognize it is completely owed to you, so it is for you, but it's also going to enable you to heal from a situation with someone else who perhaps wanted to take it from you. Okay, this could even be in the form of stealing ideas, and you're able to now heal from that situation. You also are able to take a holiday and a break, okay, because of that situation there. So it does feel, it's weird, because one of the stories I'm sort of that's plopping up is a situation where maybe you were in a business partnership with somebody else and it all went to shit, forgive my French, and now you're sort of venturing off on your own and you're doing all the hard work yourself, but then someone who you were working with in the past is basically saying, well, no, it was my idea too. And then and then you start to battle it out, even if it's a verbal battle. I do feel like you are going to be recompensed for it, and you are going to be able to heal that situation. You could also potentially be healing that relationship as well, which is really, really nice. But for others of you, if you have the opportunity just to take a bit of a breather, a bit of a holiday, the time is right for you. You do actually have the opportunity to do so. Okay, particularly if you've been burning the candle at both ends with the go the distance. So that's all I have for you, Pisces. I hope it resonated. I hope it helped. And I will see you next time. Take care. Bye.